ladies and gentlemen, Lily Savage.
Thank you. Do you know this is the first for British television licence? Honestly, it is, because underneath this gown, I am naked. I haven't even got a vest or a pair of drawers on. Naked, I tell you. Anyway, welcome to Blankety Blank for another half an hour of pure mean-spirited evil. Yes? The first cab off the rank tonight is a great actor with a string of memorable roles to his credit. He starred in my favourite comedy of all time, and I don't mean Sunset Beach, no. No, I don't mean. I mean Duty Free. Would you welcome, please, Keith Barron? Thank you. Next to Keith is a dame of the British Empire. She's one of the greatest actresses and comedians of this century, and she's given up a bingo to be here tonight. Would you please welcome the one and only Dame Thora here? Next to Dame Thora is a man who's been described as the thinking woman's crumpet.
Yeah.
His heavenly body, and he's the reason that we toss our dusters in the air on a Saturday afternoon and get stuck into grandstand. Would you please welcome Steve Ryder? Trouble comes in many guises, yes. This is a woman with a brilliant mind, but she's left it at home, unfortunately. She's currently running her own restaurant in Richmond. So you know what to avoid, don't you? She's the star of a new sitcom called Barbara. Would you please welcome Sherrie, Hewson? Sherrie is a young man who, at this moment, is hanging on my sister's wardrobe door. I don't mean like in real life, you know, I mean in the form of a poster, because he's, you know, he's been a bit nice. I wouldn't mind half an hour of dark with him, to be frank. He's currently on the road with Oh What a Night. He's a mank, and I'd like to welcome to Blankety Blank. Would you please welcome Will Mellor? On the end, we have the Black Widow of Emmerdale. Yes, beautiful but deadly. Number one shot himself. Number two ended up in a wheelchair. And number three died in a fire. And now she's got her claws into Biff. I bet they haven't renewed his contract, have they? Hey? Would you please welcome Malandra Burrows? Okay, then, let's go over and meet tonight's contestants who want to play Blankety Blank. Yes. Now, you're Debbie Heathcote.
That's right.
And you're Buxom. Oh, no, you're from Buxton. Sorry. What do you do, Debbie?
I'm a clerical assistant.
Oh, are you?
A college.
You work in a college?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you like it?
I do.
You're a fan of romantic novels?
Yeah. Nils
really?
Boone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why do you like them, then, bodice rippers? Sir Percy strode into the room and whacked his riding crop against his boots. Take me, she said. Take what you like. So he took the video and the telly. Now, this fascinates me, this. What's all this about you playing a piano?
Oh, right.
Go on, yes. Tell us. This is fascinating. This is a psychic, bit of a psychic experience, this.
In a music class, before the teacher arrived in, apparently I got up from my seat and I went over to the piano and I played a tune on the piano. And I can't play the piano.
How old were you?
I would have been about 11.
Do you think you've got, like, maybe Chopin in you or something? Do you think some great composer entered you? What is up with these people? No, you know, like, entered your body and you're floating and, nee, Mrs. Mills, maybe. Or Bobby Crush. Did your face turn orange? No. Please, would you put your hands together for Debbie here from Buxton? Thank you, Debbie. This is Keith Armstrong. Hello, Keith. How are you?
I'm fine.
And
yourself?
You're from Poole in Dorset.
Poole in Dorset, yeah.
It's a
lovely.
Very pretty place, isn't it?
Very
Matthew
nice.
Kelly lives there.
Does he?
No, I haven't ever seen him shoplifting. No. You used to be a jockey, didn't you?
I did.
Yeah.
For my sins.
And why did you give it up? Because you grew too tall or something?
I got too heavy.
What, do you have to seriously diet when you're a jockey?
Yes, I was about 6.5 stone.
Six? That's 10 Coke, 6.5 stone. But there's good stuff in small bottles, isn't there?
Poison.
Mm. Are you married?
Yes.
Because you were there, I was just going to say, you were there at the birth, not of your wife. Of your first baby.
Yes, yes. And when we... I don't know if any sort of fathers here have been in for the births.
And, half of them weren't there for the conception. Well, go on, kids, as you were saying, go on, what
and, happens? And they sort of rushed in and said, put this gown on, take
an
all your clothes
gown,
off. Well, no, it's like when you put it on the back.
Oh, yeah, backless.
With the hat. No, and I put it on, it went right to the floor, which obviously would. And they came back in. They said, "What are you doing? That's for your wife."
Anyway, listen. Best of luck tonight, Stuart.
Thank you.
Yes. Have you ever been on a game show before?
No.
No. Have you ever won anything?
Yes.
But when you were jockeying, you must have won a couple of medals or cups.
I've won some races as a jockey, and I would always say to somebody, "It's a great feeling to ride a thoroughbred racehorse in your racing
suit." Well,
no.
There's nothing like having your thighs gripped round a bit of muscle. Give him a big round of applause. Come on. So what happens is now, I'm going to read you both a question and all you have to do is fill in the missing blank or blanks. And if you match at one of our turns over there, you'll score a point. And the highest score will go on to play the Super Match game for one of our fabulous prizes. And if you get through to the head-to-head, this is the exciting bit, you could win this.
Tonight's star prize is a romantic holiday for two on the exotic island of Bali.
Anyway, you won the toss backstage, yes?
I did.
So you get to go first. Would you like A or B?
I'll have B, please.
Okay, Debbie. Now, listen carefully, and the clue is in the question, yeah? Best of luck. R. Jason was destined to be a con man. Even in the school orchestra, he was on the blank. Don't say nothing. Okay. Yeah, have a good think, Debbie, while I go over here. Well, a mooch. You right, Keith?
Yeah.
R. Jason was destined to be a con man. You know what one of them is?
Yeah.
You know. Even in the school orchestra.
Yeah.
You have to explain to you, see. He was on the blank. What's your little something off scene? Oh, I can't hear this. Press your buttons, please, when you're ready. Esther Hansen doesn't have none of this. R. Jason was destined to be a con man. Even in the school orchestra, he was on the.
Fiddle.
On the. Let's see who's got fiddle. She hasn't, I can tell. Keith, what have you got?
Fiddle!
Yes! Yeah. Come on, you little cracker. Fiddle, how are you, flower?
Better be seeing
you. And better be seeing you. We'll have a little drink later, yes?
Well,
oh, lovely. Just sort my social life out. Steve, fiddle! Oh, wonderful. Of course, Sherrie, you've got. A triangle. Right, Will. Fiddle, good lad. Malandra, what have you got?
Two scousers together, of course.
Fiddle, yeah. So you've got 1, 2, 3, you've got 5. Oh, you're going to Bali. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy. Guys. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
The Royal Marines are really tough. One Marine I know does push-ups with his blank. The Royal Marines are really tough. One Marine I know does push-ups with his, and you dare, I'm telling you.
What a Marine has.
What a Marine has. I think everybody else has. Yeah. Are you a nice uniform, they have?
Uniform? Is that a clue?
No. I'm scared to say anything, Debbie.
Oh,
you've done it. Push your buttons. Good on you. Scared to ask. You won't be going to ballet, I tell you. Honestly, telling you now. The Royal Marines are really tough. One Marine I know does push-ups with his...
one arm.
Oh, good for you. Oh, I never thought of that. So you're a nice, clean-thinking man.
They probably won't.
We're all thinking filth here. Right. Don't even say it. Keith, what have you got?
Gun.
Thora's got a gun and all. We never thought of that. Gun. What have you got, Steve?
Stiff little fingers.
I'm scared now. Go on, Shaddy, what have you got? It's what? Knots.
They tie knots, do Lady Marines, or is that
no,
sailors?
No, that's the Scouts. Tie knots. What have you got? Well, let's have a look. Nose. No, sorry. What have you got, Malandra? Malandra.
Can't we have a little finger on the end of his little arm?
No. Oh. No. There you go. Nothing down for you, love. Nothing at all.
Very difficult.
Keith, because you haven't done very well in this round, you get to go first. What would you like?
I'll try A, please.
A. Go on, might be an easier one. OK. Rolf Harris isn't that good an artist. When I took him upstairs to my bedroom, he refused to draw my blanks. Take Rolf Harris up to my bedroom. Are you sure? I'm going to now, love. Sorry. Rolf Harris isn't that good an artist. When I took him upstairs to my bedroom, he refused to draw my...
I don't know.
Press your buttons, please, when you're ready. Rolf Harris isn't that good an artist. When I took him upstairs to my bedroom, he refused to draw my...
curtains.
That's it. Good lad. Keith, what have you got?
I can't spell it, but I've put didgeridoos.
Thora.
Mine is decent for a decent show.
Picture. She's got it. Nice and clean. Draw my picture. Awful sorry, Keith. Really sorry. Would you like to come and join me, Debbie? Yes. Keith, it's been a real pleasure meeting you, but you've got to go now. I'm sorry, you're toast. Really, there you go. But you don't go away empty-handed. You get the blanksy blank checkbook and pen. Yeah, and hope you've had a good time. Thanks for coming on. See you later. Ta-ta, Keith. I'll be saying, there's Debbie from Buxton. Oh. Now, this is a super match game, and what happened here was we asked the studio audience to fill in a list of missing words to make a common phrase, and the top answers are worth 50, 100 and 150 blanks. Yeah. And you can ask for help from any three of our turns over here, and if you're not happy with the suggestions, you're free to ignore them and choose one of your own. OK?
OK. Right, yeah.
So, reveal the legend, please. Belly. Blank. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
OK, so who would you like to play with?
Right, Keith. First,
please. Belly.
Button.
Belly button.
Right. Will.
Will. Belly. Belly.
Warmers.
Belly warmers. But no, belly warmer.
He took the best one.
Belly warmer. Who else?
Malandra, please.
Belly.
Lily, one for you. Belly dance. Told you.
Belly dance. OK, now, are you happy with those, or would you like to pick one of your own?
I'll go with Keith for belly button.
So we had Keith's belly button, we had Will's warmers, and we had Malandra's Now, let's see. So you're going for button?
Yes. Right.
So for 50 blanks, we had... belly laugh. Oh, I never thought of that.
I never thought of that.
For 100 blanks, we had... dancer, Malandra. And the top answer at 150 was... You have won a digital stills camera. It's new on the market. They're marvellous, apparently.
That's great.
Yes, I think. And we might see you later on in the head-to-head. Congratulations. Right. Debbie, give her a round of applause. For OK, let's meet the next two contestants who want to play Blankety Blank. There you go. Rough like that, I tell you. Right, you're David Glover.
That's right.
Yes, and you're from East Yorks.
Yep.
Yes, and you're a student with green hair. I've got green hair. Did you dye it and it went funny? No.
I actually did it red for comic relief.
Oh, good for you.
Changed it since.
And you've gone green now. What's next?
I'm not sure.
It looks lovely. It feels lovely, you know. Honestly, like green Brillo pad sitting there on your head. Listen, I can't believe this. You're in the Mr. Man Club.
Yeah.
You get on well with Sherrie, you, honestly. You stand up a minute. Go on. Look at this. Look at this. Size of that. Look.
Step as well.
Ooh, look, look at that. Look, look. Ooh, green hair and the size of him. you in a relationship or anything?
Not at the moment.
No. No. How old are you?
20.
Oh, you're just a child. You've got a life ahead of you. One day you meet a big glamorous blonde or something. a lonely divorcee. You know what I mean? Well, it's a soft spot for young students who are 6'9" with green hair. Not more I like than a man with hair the colour of a mushy pea. Honestly. Be nice. Give him a round of applause. It's the best of luck tonight. Yeah. Hi, Michelle.
Hello.
You're Michelle Leroy Baker, yes?
I am.
And you're from Sussex?
Yes.
And you're a staff nurse?
I am.
What department are you nursing in?
Gynecology.
Ooh, are you? Got warm hands and a forceps. Ooh. Are you married?
No, single and enjoying it.
Good for you, kid. And you're a big wrestling fan, aren't you?
Well, it started out that way, but now I've become friends with the wrestlers and I actually travel around with them a lot.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
You're a wrestling groupie.
Well, you could call it that.
My mother used to be a wrestler, you know. Honest, she was. Pat Savage, the Baconhead Mauler. Ooh, she was. Ooh, no, she was. She was wonderful. You used to have it on grandstand, didn't they, the wrestling?
No, I couldn't get the right mud.
Really? Not that kind of wrestling. What's your ambitions?
I fulfilled one, and that was to swim with dolphins.
Oh, have you done that? That's very therapeutic, isn't it?
It was.
Squirting water through the hole and all this. No, apparently it's good, isn't it? Did you feel
wonderful.
Difference after this?
Yeah,
did you feel that magical?
Definitely.
I wouldn't mind doing that, but I can't swim.
I'd life jackets.
Oh, did you have a life jacket on and jumped in? The dolphins roaring, laughing, look at her in a life jacket. Best of luck, and I hope
you
enjoy the game tonight. All right. Now, you won the toss backstage, yes? So you get to go first. Would you like A or B?
I'll have B for Brenda, please.
Right, so... B for what? Brenda?
Brenda.
Brenda. Who's Brenda?
My
mum. Oh, is that your mum? Oh, give her a wave. Go on.
She's not
here. Where is she? No, I mean at the camera. You've got your hands full, haven't you, love, with this one? She went mental when she saw the towels after you'd done dyed your hair that colour. I bet she wasn't pleased. Right, you ready for this, then? Brenda's son. In 1978, Richard Madeley was elected Punk of the Year. He didn't get a medal, they just gave him another blank. Are you ready?
Yeah.
In 1978, Richard Madeley was elected Punk of the Year. He didn't get a medal, they just gave him another blank. Yeah, Richard off. Good morning.
Can I just tell you, my hair was that colour 4 hours ago.
Why? What happened?
Well, I put this stuff on at home and I got it from a charity shop for 25 and I thought, well, I'll use it because I'm, you know, giving charity. And it was black and it made me go green and it's not now.
Well, that's, you've done a good job.
No, but then I put red on the green. So if you put red on, it'll come like this. It'll be nice.
That's nice. You go out, pop in a charity shop and get it. I think it was called emulsion, the stuff she bought. Press your buttons, please, when you're ready. Are you ready, kid? Brenda's out there with her fingers crossed for you. Richard Madeley was elected Punk of the Year. He didn't get a medal, they just gave him another...
No stud.
No stud. Yep. Righty-o.
Oh.
Yes. Key.
An earring.
Near enough, but we're on the right track, aren't we, jewellery?
Mm.
We're getting there. Border. A haircut. No. That's a bit off the wall, that, but
yes,
very clever.
Not
too clever for this.
Not vulgar, is it?
No, it's not vulgar. No, no vulgarity on this show. Thank you, madam. Steve? Oh, well, a safety pin through the nose. Now, I think we can have that.
Now, this is quite logical, this answer.
A hair dye. Oh, I suppose
hair
it is.
Hair dye, hook.
No. Well,
nose ring.
Nose ring.
Oh,
that's what you said, yes.
David can kill me. Green Mohican hairdo. Sorry, David, no offence. No, all right.
Getting a lesson on fashion here off here. Right, Michelle, just make sure all your things are down. Yes, you ready? Last year, our Bunty went on an 18 to 30 holiday to Ibiza. She met so many fellas, never mind their names, she couldn't remember their blanks. Last year, our Bunty went on an 18 to 30 holiday to Ibiza. She met so many fellas, never mind their names, she couldn't remember their blanks.
You can't put
she
that.
Couldn't remember
I have to investigate this. Press your buttons, please, when you're ready.
Oh, sorry.
Jerry?
Yes.
Come on now, we're not electing a pope. year, our Bunty went on an 18 to 30 holiday to Ibiza. She met so many fellas, never mind their names, she couldn't remember the...
Faces.
Faces. Good on you. Hey. Ages. Ages.
Don't misunderstand this, will you?
Position.
You know, whether they were the manager or the cleaner.
Keep my eye on you now from now on. You're brought in to add a bit of class to this, I tell him.
Class.
Class. And you're right, and things like that. What have you got, Steve?
Oh, that's what you said, yes. Thank you.
Sherrie.
Yes?
What have you got? What's that say? Shoes?
Yes.
No. Well, what have you got?
Well, I was going to put size. And then I changed it to faces.
Good lad! Malandra, have you got love?
Not down to personal experience.
No, I bet
room
it's not.
Numbers.
Room numbers.
Sorry!
Well, you've got two. Oh, yes, okay. And you've got two, so you're neck and neck, OK?
Whoa.
Right, you know. So we start with you again, yeah? Okay. All right, then. Whoa. My hairdresser moonlights as a gardener. After he cuts your lawn, he blanks it.
Oh!
My hairdresser moonlights as a gardener. After he cuts your lawn, he blanks it.
Oh,
so after he's cut your lawn, he... Something hairdressers do.
Yeah.
Bore you to death about questions about holidays. Oh, sorry, and you won't be playing with Steve and Will. Sorry, Will. You ready? My hairdresser moonlights as a gardener. After he cuts your lawn, he...
Blow dries.
Blow dries it. Good on you. Keith, blow dries it. Now, so nothing rude.
No, this is...
Curls it. Go on then, madam. Showers it.
Shaves it.
Oh, shaves it. After he cuts your hair, he shaves it.
I'm thinking of shaving, you know. Like.
Well, sorry, not playing. Malandra.
We're on.
Blow dries it. You've got three. One, two, three, you've got four. Now, you've got to catch up now, Ped. You hear? Come on. The birdman of Alcatraz finally decided to escape when he saw the prison menu. It was blank pie for dinner. The birdman of Alcatraz, that's a smashing film, finally decided to escape when he saw the prison menu. It was blank pie for dinner. And you won't be playing with Steve or Will.
Something wrong with
you. No, I'm sorry, because you did so well, you see, last time and helped them. You can sit and chat. The birdman of Alcatraz finally decided to escape when he saw the prison menu. It was...
Pigeon pie.
Pigeon pie. Good on you. Pigeon pie. What have you got, Keith?
Budgie.
Thora, what have you got, love?
It's very original, that.
A cock robin tart. When you were in there, is that what they used to give you? Cock robin tarts?
When I was inside.
Yes. Ah, come on. Ah, Chrissy. Chrissy, what have you got? Parrot pie? No. Let's do the score now. Uh oh. Well, that makes you the winner, David. So, would you like to come and join me, please? Very sorry, you haven't, well, you have won something. You have won the highly coveted Blankety Blank checkbook and pen. Wonderful. So you don't go away empty-handed. Thanks for playing. Nice to meet you. Ta-ra. Take
Bye.
Care. See ya. Look at them legs. Look at them
Beautiful
legs. Look at the length of that.
All the way up.
I know. What do you think that got? Right, it's time for the super match now. So you know the rules, don't you, for this? Okay, good lads. Reveal the legend, please. Rubber blank. No, no, treat to have our top turns here to play with. Who are you going to pick?
Go with Sherrie.
Why? Why did we be here all night? Rubber.
Hose.
Rubber hose. Okay.
Brilliant.
Will.
Will.
Rubber band.
Rubber band.
Ooh, and Thora.
Rubber ball.
Rubber ball. So we've got Thora's ball, Sherrie's hose, and Will's band. Yeah. Are you happy with those? Are you going to pick one of your own?
I'll go with band.
Band. Okay, then. Rightio. So for 50 blanks, we had. Rubber duck.
Hot.
100 blanks, we had. Rubber band. And the top answer. Let's see the top answer. Rubber stamp. Do you know what you've won? Yeah. This is a fat prize. Seriously, you've won a banquet on the Audience Express. So you've won the Audience Express, not the train, you've won the dinner on it. But unfortunately, you haven't got enough points, right? So it's goodbye to you. We're going to welcome back Debbie. But it's been nice meeting you.
Thank
okay,
you.
Give him a round of applause. This is where we have the head-to-head, and we have to be very serious here, because this is the tense part of the programme, the intellectual bit, you know what I mean? And what we're doing is here, I ask you one further question, and you can choose one person and one person only to help you, yeah? And if you win, as well as winning your digital stills camera, you win the holiday in Bali. It's not Bali, I've just been corrected. Bali. OK, so best of luck. Would you like to choose who you're going to play with?
I'll choose Will.
Will, okay, good for you.
No!
Yes, now stand there. Put your back to him because you might cheat, you see? We don't want none of this, you know what I mean? It's not Vanessa's show. So we have to put you there, put your back to them in case you cheat, because they might do, you know what I mean? There's no eye contact allowed, you see? Okay, so fair play is observed. This is the word. Will, write it down, don't say nothing. You ready, kid?
Yeah.
Blank wishes. So it's something wishes. Have a think. Blank wishes. And best of luck. How you doing, Will? Okay.
Right,
you. Do you like to turn round? Now then, blank wishes. What's your
best?
Best wishes. I was only joking, by the way, about Bali. It's beautiful. Oh, it's gorgeous. Honestly, it's a howl, but it's gorgeous. Well, it's gorgeous. You're going to have a lovely holiday and you've got your camera and you can take loads of pictures and everything. You can take your blankety blank checkbook and pen and wear it as a hat and show off. Give it a big round of applause. Come on. I'd like to thank all our teams tonight who played. I'd like to thank Keith. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The one and only Dame Thora, my Thora, Matthew. The lovely Steve Smoldering on the end. As yellow as the canary, Sherrie. Very clever, very smart, Will. One of my closest friends and drinking partners on the end there, Malandra. Left her. Thank all our contestants who played Blankety Blank tonight. And for me, Lily Savage, good night, and I'll see you next week. Ta-da, see ya.